Saira, good morning, dear children. So today I'll be continuing the same lesson, the giant panda, class 3, subject English, part 2 and chapter 8. So in part 1, I have explained to you about the white and black Chinese bear. It is a symbol of peace in China. Female panda is called So, male panda is called Boar. And baby panda is called Ka. So giant panda is very large in size. The grown-up or adult panda is about the height of a tall person. It is about as heavy as a very big man. So it has soft fur on its body. Its color is white with black patches around the eyes, ears, shoulders, chest, legs and feet. It has a big head. Its ears are round. It has a short tail. It has sharp eyes and it can see very well. So in part 2, so giant panda lives in snowy and rocky places and walks around in the snow. Snowy means the places covered in snow or having lot of snow. Rocky places, the places covered with rocks. Giant panda lives in snowy and rocky places and it walks around in the snow. So its black and white body helps it to hide from its enemies. So its black and white body helps to hide from its enemies. So the fur on its body keeps it warm in the cold and wet mountains. So as a giant panda lives in snowy areas, so the fur on its body, the fur means the soft thick hair on its body, keeps it warm in the cold and wet mountains. So can you see the picture? The panda is the panda lives in the snowy and rocky areas and it walks around the snow. Can you see this picture of a panda? And this is the explanation of the fifth paragraph. Giant panda is a good tree climber. Panda is a good tree climber. It uses its short claws to hold on the bark of the tree. So it uses its short claws to hold onto the bark of the tree. So bark means it is the outermost layer of stems and roots of plants. It is the outermost layer of a stem of plants. And sometimes it takes afternoon naps high up in the trees. Naps means a short sleep. So panda takes afternoon short sleeps up in the trees and it cannot walk on its hind legs. Hind legs means back legs. It cannot walk on its back legs. So giant panda is a good tree climber. It uses its short claws to hold onto the bark of the tree. Sometimes it takes afternoon naps, means I told you short sleep. It sleeps high up in the trees and it cannot walk on its back legs. Can you see this picture? Panda is climbing the tree as it is a good tree climber. And this is the explanation of the sixth paragraph. Giant panda eats mostly bamboos. It eats 10 to 15 kilograms of bamboo every day. There are very few bamboo forests today. So a lot of pandas are starving. Soon we may find that there are no pandas left in the world. So giant panda eats mostly bamboos. So bamboos means it's a tall tropical plant of the grass family. So it is a tall tropical plant of the grass family. Young bamboo plants can be eaten and the hard parts of the plant are used for making furniture, paper, etc. So, the plants, young bamboo plants can be eaten and the hard parts of the plant are used for making furniture, paper, etc. So, giant panda eats mostly bamboos. So, it eats 10 to 15 kilograms of bamboos every day. So, it eats 10 to 15 kilograms of bamboo every day. So, as there are very few bamboo forests today, a lot of pandas are starving. Means, pandas are dying due to lack of food as there are very few bamboo forests today. So, we may find that there are no pandas left in the world. So, soon we may find there are no pandas left in the world because a lot of pandas are starving. So, they are dying due to lack of food as there are very few bamboo forests today. And I think you have understood. Now, I am just summarizing the whole video. Giant panda lives in snowy and rocky places and walks around in the snow. Its black and white body helps it to hide from its enemies. The fur on its body keeps it warm in the cold and wet mountains. The giant panda is a good tree climber. It uses its short claws to hold onto the bark of the tree. It cannot walk on its hind legs. Giant panda eats mostly bamboos. It eats 10 to 15 kilograms of bamboos every day. There are very few bamboo forests today, so a lot of pandas are starving. Soon we may find that there are no pandas left in the world. So, I think you have understood this video. Now, I'll be asking you some of the questions relating to this video. Where do giant pandas live? Where do giant pandas live? How does its black and white body helps? How does its black and white body helps? How does panda keep itself warm in the cold and wet mountains? How does panda keep itself warm in the cold and wet mountains? What does panda eat? Why pandas have become extinct? Why pandas have become extinct? So, these are the 5 questions that you have to answer. Go through the video, understand it, then it will be very easy for you to answer all these questions. Thank you. Sai Ram.